If you have been watching this channel for a while, you might be well aware of what you have been eating the wrong way as per Ayurvedic texts. But this video is different. In this video, we will talk about what you should eat the right way. There is this one, just one diet plan that Ayurveda suggests in all its scriptures. And it recommends it with a promise that if one follows it religiously, he or she would not need many doctors in life. Not only this, even the damage that one has done by eating the things which were not really meant for the human body, it can be reversed and the body can be healed if one just sticks to this Ayurvedic diet plan. So what is this diet plan where the food that you eat works like a medicine? Coming up the other side, stay tuned. Hello friends, welcome to FitTuber. Ayurveda is perhaps the only system of medicine that places an extraordinary emphasis on not just the food itself, but when and how it is to be eaten. Even the healthiest of foods, when eaten at wrong times, can lead to the accumulation of toxins in the body, which then results in diseases. This is what makes Ayurveda so deep and successful in treating ailments from its very root cause. How do we eat daily so that we can treat the diseases just with the food that we eat? That's what this video is all about. The number one thing that you should know before you begin eating on any given day is the time of sunrise and sunset at your location. It is between this time duration that you should eat. This is because our digestion is largely dependent on the sun. According to Ayurvedic texts, our digestive fire rises as the sun rises, gets to the peak when the sun is at its peak, and it dampens as the sun sets. Ayurveda warns that any food which is eaten after the sun has set won't properly get digested in the body. This undigested food then leads to accumulation of toxins in the body, which then results in short to long-term health issues. So now you know that there is a specific eating window for you the other times you are on a fast. Here it may sound like intermittent fasting, a popular diet in the modern era. However, it is much different as the eating window is not decided by you, but the nature decides it for yourself. Modern intermittent fasting may help you with weight loss for a while, but this diet, which is in order with the laws of the nature, will nourish your mind, body, and soul at the deepest levels. Weight loss is just a positive side effect of it. After sunset, the only thing recommended by Ayurveda is milk. This is because the specific digestive enzymes required to digest the milk are secreted in the right quantities only then. Milk also has sedative properties, so drinking warm milk before bedtime also helps you calm down, inducing a deep sleep. Now that you are familiar with your eating window, you can place your breakfast, lunch, and dinner accordingly. While choosing the three meals, you must know that even Ayurveda recommends you to eat breakfast like a king, lunch like a prince, while dinner like a pauper. However, it has a slightly different annotation to it. Breakfast like king signifies that you should be picky and choosy about the foods that you eat to break the fast. They should be well balanced with all the major macronutrients and satiating too. Then lunch like a prince. Since the prince is young and has better digestion than the king, he would eat the heaviest meal of the day. Yes, according to Ayurvedic scriptures, lunch should be the heaviest meal of the day. Now you know the reason behind it. Yes, because the sun is at its peak. So here is the thing, if you want to indulge in sweets, eat that outside meal once in a while. Lunchtime is ideal. Next, dinner like a pauper. Since the sun is about to set, one cannot afford to digest a lot of food, so the dinner should be kept light. According to Ayurveda, there are some foods which are strictly prohibited during dinner. These are bananas, radish, curd, and cucumbers. These are extremely cold-natured foods which the body fails to digest properly when the sun is down. The next question arises, breakfast, lunch, and dinner is all fine, but what exactly should I eat? Don't worry, Ayurveda has very specifically mentioned the ideal characteristics of ahar. The food that you eat should check the 5 boxes. It should be sattvic, it should be seasonal, it should be local, it should be fresh, and it should be tasty. What is sattvic? Derived from the word sattva, food full of goodness is called sattvic. The traditional system of Ayurveda divides foods into 3 kinds, sattvic, rajasic, and tamasic. Sattvic foods are synonymous to modern day wholesome foods. These include fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, fresh cow dairy, whole grains and legumes. They come directly from the mother nature and are nourishing for the mind, body and soul. Now when these same foods are cooked in excess of salt, sugar, spices or eaten too cold or hot to satisfy the palate, they make the mind restless. These foods are termed rajasic. Then there are tamasic foods. These are foods of ignorance. They include frozen foods, stale food, intoxicating foods, preservative laden packaged foods and all non-vegetarian foods. When these are eaten, they wreak a havoc physically as well as mentally. So the more sattvic food you eat, the better it is. The next important quality of food is that it should be seasonal. Ayurveda stresses that one should eat food which is in season, not in fashion. Consider mangoes. If they are out of season, they will be sour and eating them will cause acidity. Similarly, every food which is in season will provide the best possible nourishment. So go to a local vegetable market, know what's in season, buy it and eat it. Thirdly, food eaten should be local. That is why I have always recommended to choose coconuts over avocados. No doubt avocados are healthy, but they are foreign to Indians. There is a reason why nature grows certain food in a specific region. It's to suit the people of that region. Food which grows within the 100 km radius of your location is local, and that food when eaten gets properly assimilated by your body. Don't know how to find which food is seasonal and local? A simple hack is to go to a nearby shop and look for the cheapest fruits and vegetables. Next, the food should be fresh, Ayurveda suggests. Even Bhagavad Gita in one of its shlokas clearly mentions that a food prepared should be eaten within 3 hours. The fresher the food you eat, the more it will foster your health. So eating refrigerated so-called health foods will do more harm than good. Finally, the food should be tasty. Yes, Ayurveda makes it clear that no matter how nutritious a food may be, if you don't find it delicious, you can't receive all its benefits. This breaks the myth that healthy diet isn't palatable. That doesn't mean that you hop on Maggi. Anyway, it doesn't check the first 4 boxes. I guess this makes it very clear as to what food is best for us to eat. Subsequently, the question arises, how much food should I eat? For this, Ayurveda confirms that you don't need to ask any dietitian but your own stomach. Ancient texts affirm that if one eats consciously, focused on eating, chewing and relishing every bite, the stomach itself signals when it's full. On the contrary, if you eat in front of the screens, talking over the phone or in between the conversations, you will miss out on satiety signals and as a result you will overeat. So save yourself from the hassle of counting every calorie that you intake, just listen to your body and eat according to your appetite. The same goes true for water as well. How much water should you drink on a daily basis depends upon person to person. Again, listen to your body. If you are thirsty, drink it slowly, sip by sip. Our body gets good amount of water from other food sources like fruits and vegetables as well. However, there is one time when water should be drunk even if you are not thirsty. That is first thing in the morning upon waking up. In Ayurvedic scriptures, it is referred to as Ushapan. It is mentioned that at night when we sleep, the body gets to healing process, accumulating the toxins. Then upon waking up, when we drink water before brushing, it flushes the toxins off the body, cleansing the intestines. At this time, it is ideal to drink over 1 liter of water. After drinking water, you should freshen up and then proceed to the main meals of the day. So that gives you deep insight as to why and how you should manage your diet in tune with the nature. If we summarize it, first thing in the morning, upon waking up, drink a lot of water. Freshen up. After this, every food that you intake should be within the window of sunrise and sunset. Then plan your breakfast like a king. It should be full of nutrition but still not very heavy. Lunch should be the heaviest. Dinner should be light. Some foods are prohibited in dinner. Food eaten throughout the day should check the 5 boxes. You can include fresh fruits and vegetables before the main meals, not after. Milk is the only food which can be and should be consumed after sunset. So this completes your full day Ayurvedic diet plan. If you align yourself with the laws of nature and eat according to what is prescribed in our ancient texts, something powerful will happen. Every day your body will have ample time to heal the damage done before and slowly all your health issues will come to an end. As it is rightly said in Chandogya Upanishad, Ahara Suddhau Sattva Shuddhi. Give it a shot. I want to thank Oziva for partnering with us for this video. Have you got hold of Oziva's protein and herbs made separately for men and women? Yes, these are 2 unique whey proteins with added herbs. One scoop of the men version will give you 23 grams of protein, 5.5 grams of BCAA, multivitamins and herbs like ashwagandha and moringa for better stamina and recovery. While a scoop of women version will give you 23 grams of protein, 5.5 grams of BCAA, multivitamins and herbs like shatavari and tulsi for better hormonal balance. Not only this, Oziva protein and herbs is sweetened naturally with stevia and has no artificial sweeteners, preservatives or soy. These are truly one of its kind products in the Indian market. I highly recommend these to you. To buy them, click on the link down in the description box. Do not forget to apply the special discount coupon to get rupees 150 off on your order. So friends, that's all for this video. I hope you found it to be helpful. If yes, then please show me your support by giving this video a big thumbs up. What next would you like to see on this channel? Comment below. You can now support my work on Patreon so that I can bring more well-researched videos for you. Please do remember to subscribe to my channel, hit that bell icon so that you never miss a video from me. You can also follow me on Instagram where I regularly do Q&A sessions. My name is Vivek. I thank you so much for watching.